The Philippine government surpasses its tax collection target for July. The Bureau of Internal Revenue collected 273.1 billion pesos in taxes last month. The Tax Bureau initially set a collection target of 13 billion pesos. That amount is also higher compared to the 75 billion pesos collected for the same period last year. This brings the cumulative collection from January to July 2023 to 1.4 trillion pesos. The implementing rules and regulations of the Philippines' first national investment fund set to take effect on September 12. Finance Chief Benjamin Diokno told reporters the Maharlika Fund's IRR was published in the Official Gazette on Monday. The rules take effect 15 days after publication. Diokno also says a search has begun for the president and CEO of the corporation that will manage the fund. President Marcos signed a controversial bill that created the MIF in July, despite strong opposition.
In related news, the Bureau of Customs says a 20% commission awaits tipsters on smuggled or hoarded goods. Customs Commissioner Bienvenido Rubio said there is an existing reward system under the Customs Modernization and Tariff Act. The reward is equivalent to 20% of the value of the goods reported as smuggled or hoarded. But the informant will not be entitled to the cash reward if the confiscated goods were donated or declared for official use by the government.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. wants the government to find ways to control rice prices. The president says relevant government agencies should utilize all available legal tools to bring down the price of the staple. In a sectoral meeting recently held in Malacañang, Marcos voiced concern over the spike in rice prices, which has been attributed to hoarding, the effects of storms, and the added costs posed by middlemen. The president, who is also concurrent agriculture chief, called on the Bureau of Customs to work with the Agriculture Department to study the possibility of donating confiscated rice to the Social Welfare Agency. On the line, our correspondent Katrina Domingo to tell us about the visit of UK Foreign Secretary James Cleverly. Kat?
Hi, Ron. The Philippines and the United Kingdom have agreed to develop a framework that would define the scope of its bilateral ties with the foreign secretaries of both countries, underscoring the need for closer cooperation amid pressing and evolving regional and international issues of mutual concern. The joint statement of intent to develop a framework agreement was signed during the visit of UK Foreign Secretary James Cleverly here in Manila, and it is designed to build on exchanges of the two countries that have been undertaking in the areas of defense, security, maritime, climate, economy, as well as people-to-people ties. Now, Philippine Foreign Affairs Secretary Enrique Manalo says it also signals the strengthening of the bilateral ties between Manila and London in the sectors of trade, investment, security, and maritime cooperation, among other fields. The two foreign secretaries made no mention of China and the tensions in the West Philippine Sea, but underscored that the Philippines and the UK's relationship are founded on the shared values that respect openness, freedom, and respect the rule of law and the adherence to that rule of law. Cleverly also noted that the UK is building enduring partnerships in the Philippines, is one of those key partners, and he says the UK is looking forward to sharing knowledge on maritime law, promoting maritime domain awareness, as well as enhancing maritime protections along with the Philippines. Cleverly actually visited the Philippine Coast Guard earlier to hear about the work they do to uphold the UNCLOS and protect the maritime environment in Philippine waters. Cleverly also had a meeting with Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., and he noted that this is a good time that this is an exciting time for both the Philippines and the United Kingdom, as the bilateral trade between the two countries is at its highest level in its history, which now stands at 2.4 billion euros annually in terms of goods and services. Ron?
Thanks for the update, Katrina Domingo.
The Philippines and Australia aiming to hold more joint military exercises following the conclusion of the Indo-Pacific Endeavor 2023, also known as Exercise Alon. AFP Chief General Romeo Bronner thanked Australia's continued support to the country as he welcomed General Angus Campbell, Chief of the Australian Defence Force, in a courtesy call on Tuesday. For General Campbell, the military drills highlight the importance of cooperation among allies to achieve mutual benefit and partnership.